Normally, before a fight, I try to do a little bit of research on a fighter, watch a few fights, look at some interviews. But basically, this guy that Robert Guerrero is fighting this week, right now it is August the 24th, 2016, on T-Street Controversy. This is T-Street Controversy Live. I cover every single major fight live. This Friday, PBC on Spike, it's a double event. It's not in the same arena, of course, but you're going to have PBC on Spike with Alfredo Angulo, who's going to be fighting, and then you're going to have Robert Guerrero versus David Emmanuel Peralta. He is, what is he? He is 25-2-1 with 14 KOs. Looking at his resume, he hasn't fought anybody of note that you may know of. And basically, this is just a fight to get Robert Guerrero a win and to get him a knockout and possibly build him up to maybe fight Andre Berto in a rematch. Now, you think that is Robert Guerrero, what they say, a gatekeeper? I don't know. Right now, he's not looking too good. He's looking, you know, like just a tad below gatekeeper. If you look at the fact that the Aaron Martinez fight, in my opinion, he should have lost, that would mean that he lost, what, he would be 1-4 in his last five fights, you know, if it wasn't for the Aaron Martinez win and the Yoshihiro Kamagai win. But when it comes to Floyd Mayweather, of course he lost. He had a very, very good fight on PBC. It was the PBC opener with Keith Thurman. And then he had that fight where, depending on the referee, he was out on his feet. You know, he was out on his feet. You know, he had that fight with Aaron Martinez, and then, of course, he lost to Danny Garcia. So he couldn't come back and fight a guy that, you know, he would likely lose to. That's not how Al Heyman works. He's an Al Heyman fighter. Who is going to be fighting is this Peralta guy, and he's got, you know, 14 KOs. And let me see. He last lost. He is 1-2, 1-1, 1 draw, 1 split decision loss in his last four fights. The last time he fought was in May of 2015, and that was against a guy in an eight-round fight who was 22-25-3, you know? The last time this guy's got a knockout, I got to look at his age, too. Let me see. The last time this guy got a knockout was in 2012. There was a third-round TKO in a 10-round fight against a guy who was 9-6 at the time. How old is this guy? This guy is, what is he, 33 years old? You know, from, I be wondering, like, where the fuck are they be finding these people? You know, I mean, wonder, no disrespect, you know, because we've seen crazy things happen in boxing where, you know, for example, when Nobuhiro Ishida, you know, beat James Kirkland, you know, but it's like sometimes I be wondering, like, where the fuck did they be getting these people from? Like, who is watching these guys? Like, yo, let's call up Parada, put him in there with Robert Guerrero. Like, yeah, yes. Like, where do they find these guys? You know, who's this matchmaker? How do they, you know, is there somebody who sits and watches tapes of, like, VHS tapes of these fighters and say, you know what? You know, that guy's going to be good for Robert Guerrero. You know? But, you know, I can understand what they're doing. You know, that's just how PBC works. That's just how Heyman works. Is like, well, listen, Danny, you got the big fight against Danny Garcia. Now let's get you some wins under your belt and start pushing you towards, you know, a bigger fight. Because right now, when you look at the 147-pound landscape, Robert Guerrero ain't beat no Errol Spence, in my personal opinion. Errol Spence will probably end him. You know? Like, end him. He's not beating a Sean Porter, in my opinion. He's not beating a, definitely not a, not a Keith Thurman rematch. You know, he doesn't even beat Carol Brook, you know, in my personal opinion. I'm not being disrespectful, but look what we've seen from Robert Guerrero. He hasn't shown us anything, and he's not the same fighter that he used to be. Robert Guerrero used to have a machine-like jab, man. You know, a machine like Jeff, and, you know, he used to put nice, efficient body work together. You know, he used to trade hands with you. I'm talking about, like, on some technical shit. Now, this CrossFit slugger smothering his punches, you know, warrior style, you know, Grand Theft Auto fucking Ruben Cholo shirt. Cholo shirt wearing, you know, saying it Dreyas and shit, man. But anyway, it's going to be PBC on Spike. August the 27th, 2016, on T-Street Controversy. This is T-Street Controversy Live. I cover every single major fight live. Follow me on Twitter at T-Street Live. Follow me on Instagram at TST Controversy. Follow me on Facebook at T-Street Controversy Live. All the links are right down below. And of course, right after the fight, we're going to be doing a live stream where we're going to be talking about boxing and the events of the night, boxing news of the week, and so on and so on. So check out the channel. You'll see all the links to my live streams. And I try to make my live streams as as entertaining and laid back as possible. Also, stay tuned for the website, fightview360.com, which is going to be a total, you know, innovative, and I'm not using that word loosely, innovative approach on helping the sport of boxing. You know? So whether you agree with my methods or not, whether you don't like the shit I post on my social media or not, you know, it's all for a purpose. You know, just bear with me and deal with it. So please subscribe. All the links down below in the description box. T-Street Controversy, T-Street Controversy Live.